Okay, this is Dr. Bhupesh once again from Dr. BKM Institute, and today we will discuss the letter. As we have already seen that today's letter is a discharge back letter, we have not seen any other aspect of the letter. But up to this moment, I have told you only one thing, that whenever you are writing OET letter in the OET exam, it is very important to note the address. Because over here in this particular letter, the address has been given that write a letter to the supervisor. So the first thing I always say you, the most important thing is to whom we are writing the letter. That is the most important, because we select data according to that thing, to whom we are writing the letter. Letter kisko likh rahe hain. So that is the most important thing. But apart from this, always note the address as well. Addresses are very important, like in this case, that you are writing a discharge letter to the Eventide Residential Aged Care, 33 Lepona, Victoria, Maine. So you are writing the letter to this person residing at this address. So when you go back on the first page of the letter and you see the permanent address of the patient is also the same, Eventide Residential Aged Care, that means that the patient already belongs to residential aged care. That means patient is living in this particular residential aged care. What does it mean? It means that these people, the residential aged care people have idea of social history and medical history. That means there are two ways of attempting this letter. So I'm just going to tell you the brief how to attempt these letter. So I will make a special video for this thing. So there are three punches which are very important. First punch, I am writing this letter regarding one of your residents. Patient ka naam, Mr. X, who was admitted, ya who was referred to us for this and this purpose. This will always be the first line of letters like these. Suppose if this would not have been the residential home, if this would have been a doctor, family doctor or patient's GP, agar ye patient ke GP nahi bheja hota aur patient ka family doctor hota, in that case, we would have written, I am writing this letter regarding one of your patients who was referred to us for this and this purpose. Forgive me for the spelling mistake, because I belong to medical profession, so my spellings are not exactly, but my spelling on computers are such. So I'm writing this letter regarding one of your residents, Mr. X. But if that would have been his GP, agar aap GP se refer kiya hota aur hum GP ko wapis bhej rahe hote, to hum likhte hain, I am writing this letter regarding one of your resident who was referred to us, jo bhi uski problem thi for this and this thing. So you say now. So uske baad full stop, next line always would be now. His condition is better and hence he is being discharged back into your care, and you are advised to follow few instructions for his speedy recovery. So that means you always have to use this first paragraph. Normally in the last line we say, so in the other letters we say, so she is being discharged. So she is being discharged into your care, because we tell the problem that she requires full-time assistance in the normal. So she is being referred into your care. So these are the normal letters. Jo aapko ma'am ne, she is being discharged in, so she is being, she requires, so she is being referred to you. So in the normal letters, we do this thing in the normal letters. जो आपको मैम ने सिखाए हैं नॉर्मल लेटर्स. बट व्हेन इट इज द लेटर ऑफ डिस्चार्ज बैक, तो आप कभी ऐसे नहीं कहते शी रिक्वायर्स फुल टाइम असिस्टेंस इसलिए आपके पास भेज रहे हैं. तो नॉर्मल लेटर्स में हम ये कहते हैं शी रिक्वायर्स फुल टाइम असिस्टेंस सो शी इज बीइंग रेफर्ड टू यू. बट ये हम तब कहते हैं क्योंकि उसको फुल टाइम असिस्टेंस चाहिए होती है, बट इन द लेटर्स ऑफ डिस्चार्ज बैक वी डू नॉट यूज दिस लाइन, दिस इज नॉट यूज्ड। व्हाई? क्योंकि हम ये कहना चाहते हैं दैट पेशेंट अगर ठीक, कंप्लीटली भी ठीक हो जाता, इफ पेशेंट वुड हैव रिकवर्ड कंप्लीटली, इवन देन ही वुड हैव गेन ही वुड हैव गोन टू द सेम एड्रेस, इवन देन ही वुड हैव बीन डिस्चार्ज बैक इन टू यूअर केयर। सो नेवर से दैट पेशेंट नीड्स केयर, दैट इज वाई वी आर सेंडिंग। ऑलवेज से हिज कंडीशन इज बेटर, हैंस ही इज बीइंग डिस्चार्ज बैक इन टू यूर केयर। हिज कंडीशन इज बेटर, इस कारण से हम आपके पास वापिस भेज रहे हैं, एंड यू आर एडवाइज टू फॉलो फ्यू इंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर हिज स्पीडी रिकवरी। सो दिस इज द सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट पंच दैट यू हैव टू राइट इन दिस लेटर्स। देन नॉर्मली वट इज द सेकेंड मिस्टेक? नॉर्मली इन इंस्टीट्यूट इट इज बींग टॉट दैट यू से एज यू नो, दिस इज द सेकंड, दिस इज द थर्ड पंच से दे से, एज यू नो शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज। सो बच्चों को ये सिखाया जाता है कि आपने ये पंच कह दिया शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज, बट दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी नोटेड, दिस लाइन इज नॉट कंप्लीट बिकॉज यू हैव टू कंप्लीट द लाइन एज यू नो शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज। सो शी वॉज गिवन डायबिटिक केयर ड्यूरिंग हर हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन। वट आई वॉन्ट टू से, वेन अ सेंटेंस स्टार्ट विद एज, इट इज नेवर कंप्लीटेड विदाउट सो। एज क्योंकि उसको डायबिटीज है, एज शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज, एज यू नो शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज, सो शी वॉज गिवन डायबिटिक केयर ड्यूरिंग हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन। सो दैट इज द थर्ड मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पंच यू हैव टू डू, बट इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट यू हैव टू राइट एज यू नो। यू कैन यूज दिस एज यू नो लेटर ऑन एज वेल। वट यू कैन डू इन दिस केस, सोशल हिस्ट्री एंड मेडिकल हिस्ट्री इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज द पेशेंट इज गोइंग बैक एंड दे ही वॉज रेफर्ड टू अस बाय रेजिडेंशियल एज केयर ओनली। सो यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट सोशल हिस्ट्री एंड मेडिकल हिस्ट्री उनको पहले से ही पता होगा। रेजिडेंशियल एज केयर मस्ट बी नोइंग अबाउट द सोशल हिस्ट्री एंड मेडिकल हिस्ट्री ऑफ द पेशेंट। सो यू नीड नॉट राइट द सेकेंड पैराग्राफ ऑफ सोशल हिस्ट्री एंड मेडिकल हिस्ट्री। इन दैट केस इफ यू डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू यूज एज यू नो, यू कैन सिंपली से ड्यूरिंग हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन। पेशेंट वॉज गिवन, यू कैन सिंपली स्टार्ट। सो देर इज नो रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दिस लाइन ऑल्सो, सो देर इज नो रिक्वायरमेंट। बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू यूज दिस लाइन देन यू से एज यू नो ड्यूरिंग हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन, एज यू नो शी इज हैविंग डायबिटीज, सो शी वॉज गिवन। आप ऐसा भी लिख सकते हो, एज यू नो दैट ऑन एडमिशन द पेशेंट, आप ऐसा भी लिख सकते हो, द पेशेंट वॉज हैविंग पेन सो शी वॉज गिवन पेन किलर्स। आप ऐसा भी शुरू कर सकते हो, मतलब जरूरी नहीं है आपको डिजीज ढूंढनी है, बस आपको ये लाइन बनानी है कि जैसा कि आपको पता है, एज यू नो दैट ऑन एडमिशन द पेशेंट वॉज हैविंग पेन। अगर हम इस लेटर की बात करें, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर लेटर, लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम, आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू मिक्स अप। सो इफ वी से द पेशेंट मैगी गोल्डस्टीन 60-year-old अजमेर डिजीज सफरर करंटली एडमिटेड टू अवर हॉस्पिटल फॉर अ डिसलोकेटेड एल्बो आफ्टर अ फॉल। सो शी हैज बीन हेयर फॉर 5 days, और डिस्चार्ज डेट इज आफ्टर 12th November, एंड ओवर देयर दे हैव सेड अस दैट पेशेंट हैज बीन इन अवर केयर फॉर वॉज 3 days ago। सो लेट से दिस वे दैट वी आर राइटिंग द लेटर ऑन 8 + 3, 11th of November, एंड द पेशेंट विल बी डिस्चार्ज टूमोरो। सो लेट अस टेक इट दिस वे बिकॉज इन द लास्ट इट हैज बीन गिवन दैट पेशेंट वॉज एडमिटेड 3 days ago। सो 8 + 3, 11। सो सपोज टूडेज डेट इज 11, सो इफ टूडेज डेट इज 11, सो दैट इज द थर्ड थिंग इन दिस लेटर। दिस इज अ वेरी ट्रिकी लेटर। सो इफ दिस है, प्लीज प्लीज लिसन टू दिस रिकॉर्डिंग लाइक एटलीस्ट 3-4 times एंड लिसन टू इट टिल द एंड, ओनली देन यू वुड बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड। सो प्लस 3 days इज 11th November एंड दे आर सेइंग डिस्चार्ज डेट इज 12, दैट मीन्स पेशेंट विल बी डिस्चार्ज टुमोरो। सो द पेशेंट विल बी डिस्चार्ज टुमोरो। एडमिशन डायग्नोसिस दैट पेशेंट वॉज एडमिटेड ड्यू टू डिसलोकेटेड राइट एल्बो and I had early dementia, but this would not be a problem for the admission. So during admission, you should write this thing, dislocated right elbow. So what have we done during hospitalization? Management, medically stable, era. Ready for the discharge back, right elbow in the cuff without sling, healing slowly. So basically they have applied the cuff in the cuff with sling. So how we right elbow in cuff with sling, okay, and healing slowly. So how can we mix in this particular letter is that, so we will say, I'm writing first paragraph, I'm writing this letter regarding one of you who was admitted to our hospital. So in the first line, we will say who was admitted to our hospital due to dislocated elbow. In this letter, we will write this way. So now his condition is better, hence he is being discharged back into your care and you are advised to follow few instructions for his speedy recovery. So that is how you write the first paragraph. Second paragraph, you will say, as you know that on admission, she had dislocated elbow. So cuff was applied. So cuff was sling, cuff with sling was applied. The wound is healing well. So that is how you will mix up this particular letter. That is how you use in practicality when you write these sentences. So I've given you just one of the examples. So let's see what exactly is our letter now. So I've explained you these things. So these are the three punches. And also, if you do not put the punch, like if you have used the second paragraph, oxidone spouse will collect when this is a very, again, that has there is not much data given in this, so there is no point of talking about this letter too much. That I will explain you without the recording, so that you know other students who have not joined Dr. BKM, if they are listening to video, they do not get confused. Of course, to you I will explain everything nicely, but over here for the time being, what I'm going to do for the rest of the people is that I want to complete this recording of discharge back letter. So please listen to it like 5-10 times. Only then you will be able to understand. Otherwise you will not be able to understand. So first paragraph, I am writing this letter regarding one of the resident who was admitted to our hospital due to this. Now his condition is better, hence he is being discharged back into care. And you are advised to follow few instructions for his speedy recovery. Now, if the second paragraph you said during hospitalization, the patient was given. So you are missing out on the third punch, as you know. But this, as you know, can be used later on as well, as you know, in the last discharge plan, as you know, the patient is having diabetes. So diabetic diet should be given after discharge. So you can use this punch in the last as well. So it is all about you. Examiner will get really impressed with this third punch of yours. When you say the first punch is one of your resident, the second punch is hence he is being discharged back because condition is better and you are advised to follow few instructions. So please do not write that he needs care, so he is being discharged back. So never write this way in these letters, because even if he would not have required the care, he would have still been discharged back to the same place, because he has come from the place, he lives in that place, he's one of the residents of that place. So we are not sending him because he requires care, we are sending him because he belongs to that place. So that is what I want to tell you precisely. So always use this line. And the third punch, either in the first line of the second paragraph, as you know that on admission the patient was having pain. So I have tell you, as you know that she had dislocated elbow, so cuff with sling was applied and the wound is healing well. So you can mix up like this. So I have given you an example of the letter of today as well. Otherwise you can write simply during hospitalization, cuff with sling was applied and the wound is healing well. So you can write it this way as well. And in the last, you will say, as you know, the patient is having diabetes, so diabetic diet should be given after discharge. So this can also be used in the last as well. So please do not make it an issue that you have to use it here only, because you have used the punch here and you have used the punch here. We have got many good results which I have forwarded you in the group as well, which you are getting on daily basis, the results. And this was the kind of the letter that came the last time, just in the April or May, April exam. So this was the letter that came of discharged back. So these are very important letters. It might come. So please listen to this recording 3-5 times so that you can understand everything about it. And now I'm gonna stop the recording and we'll take your doubts. We'll take your questions about today's letter and we'll explain you today's letter again. But still, I would like to ask you a question first because it is a little complicated. So I don't want to make you feel discomfort. So it's better to ask questions. So I'm stopping the recording at the moment. This is Dr. Bhupesh from Dr. BKM Institute. Thank you.